Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good to see you on here. Whoever is jumping on live, say hello, good morning. Tell me what you're up to on this Friday. Do you like new clothes? Let's talk about new clothes, all right? Yeah, my shirt I'm wearing right now is new. It's a little funky. It's a little colorful design-wise. This vestie is not new. I've had this since I lived in Pennsylvania. In fact, I think I got it at a Salvation Army on 50% off day for like $1.50 when we lived up north. So I was like, oh, this goes cute. So, but let's talk about new clothes spiritually. In Ephesians 4, 22 and 24, it says, you were taught with regard to your former way of life to put off your old self and to put on the new self, right? You were taught with regard to your former way of life to put off your old self and to put on the new self. Living the Christian life should become as natural to us as changing clothes. We take off the old and we put on the new. The old may have been comfortable, but it's dirty and horribly out of fashion in our new kingdom. Did you get that? Our old clothes are dirty and out of fashion in the new kingdom that we should be living in. The new is the permanent style of the kingdom of heaven, and it will cause us to resemble God increasingly. Our responsibility is to continually shed what is no longer appropriate and put on the clothes we have been given. But many of us walk an unwise path. We claim citizenship in the new kingdom, but continue to wear the fashions of the old. In trying to fit in everywhere, we find that we fit in nowhere. We may blend into the old kingdom, but we no longer have proper ID there. We have the proper ID for the new kingdom, but we're slow to fit in. Either way, it's an awkward situation to be in. Does anybody feel me there? Comment below if you feel that once in a while. Good morning, good morning. Thank you for tuning in. What is our reluctance? Why do we hesitate to put on our new clothes? Because we know we will experience rejection. Nobody likes rejection, right? Do you like rejection? No, none of us like rejection. But rejection will come. Rejection will come to everyone, either from the world or from the kingdom of heaven. Unfortunately, there's rejection everywhere. The question is not whether we can avoid it, but whose we most want to avoid. Wisdom calls for a choice. Trying to dress for both kingdoms is not a viable option. Are you reluctant to place both feet firmly in the kingdom of God? Are you reluctant to do that? Do you try to hang on to remnants of your former citizenship? Do you try to hold on to things of the past? Maybe you've discovered in your attic a bin of things from old boyfriends or old remnants, or, oh, he gave me his shirt. I actually found a shirt last week of a guy, not Robert, who gave me his t-shirt. I don't know where it came from, but I was rooting through boxes of stuff in the garage and came across it. And I thought, oh, should I use this for a cleaning rag? No, I just pitched it. We don't need the old remnants around, right? We don't need them. Shed that, let go of them, let them go. Shed them like an old set of ragged clothes. The way to settle into your new kingdom and advance in it is to be reclothed. It's a daily process. I'm not gonna lie. It takes time, it takes patience on yourself. And we deny We need to deny deceitful desires, like in verse 22, Ephesians 4. You're going to follow along. It's Ephesians 4, verse 22, 23, and 24. Okay? So we deny deceitful desires and saturate ourselves in a new attitude. Three things. We deny deceitful desires. We saturate ourselves in a new attitude. Okay? And then we become like God in righteousness and holiness. There's no greater wisdom than this. Saturate yourself in a new attitude. New attitude. I'm trying to teach one of my daughters this. You are a daughter of the King. And just because the enemy might come along and put a thought in your mind, you do not entertain it. You let it flee. You bounce your mind to something else. You bounce your eyes to something else. Whatever you have to do, you think of a verse. If you can't think of one right away, then that's why it's important to have a book in front of you, a Bible, a card, maybe a note card in your pocket. We've been having to write little notes of I am a daughter of the King. I am loved. I'm treasured. I'm beautiful. I'm special. I will defeat the enemy. And then a Bible verse. We've been having her put that in her pocket. She discovered that her spandex shorts under her skirt has a pocket. I just bought them new shorts the other day. Mom, these have pockets. I'm like, perfect. It's a great place for your note. Not that you're going to reach up under your skirt and pull it out when you need it, but there, when you need to take a bathroom break, you got something positive to read. So, we can do all kinds of things to defeat the enemy, but putting on new clothes
and teaching our children this too, everybody likes something new.
But we can correlate this with our spiritual life to get rid of the old. Get rid of the old and let's put on new garments, because we are in the kingdom. We are kingdom builders, kingdom influencers. We are a child of, daughter of the King. Amen.
Amen. If you agree, say amen. If you agree, say yes or yes. Amen. So happy Friday to you guys. I hope you have a really awesome day. I'm going to say a prayer right now to just bless your day, your weekend. I likely will not be doing a live tomorrow and Sunday.
We have a lot going on. We have Seabreeze camp meeting this weekend, and Kalina's singing in it tonight, and Natalie's actually singing in the service this morning. So lots going on this weekend as well. But let's say prayer, all right?
Bow with me. Thank you, Father, so much for your loving kindness, Lord, and teaching us new things and
helping us to see a little correlation between old clothes and new clothes. Thank you, God, for the purpose that I love how you love analogies and realistic things. And thank you, Lord, for these moments of just helping our hearts understand a little bit deeper how truly, deeply you want us to walk with you and how we can. I thank you, God, for my friends, the viewers, those that might be stopping by this wall to watch and get a little encouragement in their day today. I pray that you would bless their hearts today, that you would bless their lives today, bless whatever their hand finds to do, that they would do it with all their might, like our verse and like our session was yesterday. Lord, I pray that you would help us, whichever we find our hands to do, that we would do it with all of our might and do it unto you, Lord, and not unto ourselves and not unto pleasing someone else. Lord, help us to please you more. Help us to have that in our heart and in our devotion and in our intention, Lord, to be intentional on bent on pleasing you. Lord,
Thank you for your word. Thank you for teaching us. Thank you for reaching us where we are. Thank you for encouraging us. Thank you for these winter months where we can kind of hone in and we can cozy up with a cup of coffee or tea, and we can just do things that are good for our hearts, do things that are good for our soul. And bringing ourselves to your word is the one sure way of how we can grow deeper with you, Lord. And I pray that you would bless all of my friends who are doing that today. Those that aren't doing it, I pray, God, you would just reach them where they are and encourage them and draw them to you, Lord. Thank you, God, for where you've brought us so far already in this first week of February. I can't believe how fast it's already flown. But, Lord, I pray that everything that we do and say today may be pleasing in your sight. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Thank you, God. In your name, amen. Amen and amen. Yes. Thank you guys for watching. Go ahead and share this video with someone that you feel it could use the encouragement today. All right? Like it, share it, sprinkle it. All right. I hope you guys have a really awesome day, and make it a creative, clean one. All right? Do something special for yourself today. Go buy a new shirt, a new outfit, a new clothing piece. Don't go all out. You don't need to go all out. You can go to the thrift store. You got $5 in your pocket, I guarantee you, you can go buy a nice top or a nice skirt or a little dress, or even a cute hat, okay? Get yourself something new, but get rid of something old. And while you do that, think of how Ephesians 4:22 says, you were taught with regard to your former way of life to put off your old self and put on your new self. So pray a little prayer as you treat yourself to something new and say, Lord, help me to put off this attitude. Help me to put off anger. Help me to put off selfishness. Help me to put off lust. Help me to put off whatever. And God will help you. He'll change you in a tangible way. I believe it. I guarantee it. And I love you guys. Have a really awesome Friday. Bye-bye.